Hi friends, welcome back to the class. Today I am going to explain the chapter physical and chemical changes. So I will give you once again the meaning on the class about the physical and chemical changes. So it is a very interesting chapter. Now we are going to learn the only changes about our life and the surroundings nature. So which type of changes we are seeing in everyday life? So first one, day night is also one type of change, and the flowering and ripening the fruit, and this type of changes everyday we are seeing. So here we want to know the changes, what is mean by physical change, what is mean by the chemical change, and these changes also different types, that means desirable change, undesirable change. What is mean by this type of changes? So let's see first one, the start is the chapter physical and chemical change. What is mean by physical change? So this change, physical change, means it is a temporary change. There is no new substances formed. But it's change only particular time only. For example, we are elastin that rubber, what happen after releasing the force that come to the normal stage. So this type of change is called a physical change. So what about the chemical change? The chemical change is a permanent change and new substances formed. So the example, the rusting of iron. You know what is mean by rusting of iron? That means that iron piece contain one more surface crust, means rust present over the iron, means that is iron going to degrade slowly. So it cannot be reversed. It is a permanent change. And the ripening the fruit. Ripening the fruits. What happens once come to the fruit, then can't change to the seed. So this type of change is called a permanent change. So here, when the changes take place, the substance may change their color on the shape and the state. What happened? When changes take place, the substance may be changed in their color, shape and state. What is mean by the first change, color? For example, one fruit, immature fruit, seed, after few days after the turn to yellowish color or reddish color. So this color change, green to red, green to yellow. So it is type of change is permanent. It is one of the example related to color. And the shape, for example, fruits and seeds also. First starting the seeds only small in size, and gradually it's an increase in the size and come to the mature the fruit. So what happened? Few days before is a small in size, after few days whatever is a bigger in size. So this type of change is also example of permanent change. So that's shape is become change. And the state also. For example, one salt become going to break using the hammer, using some other powerful things. What happened? That change into small pieces. So what happened in the state? Otherwise that you take the ice cube and given the temperature into this ice cube, what happened? That salt change into liquid. It is also one type of change. In all our surroundings, we are seeing the different types of change in every day. So here, changes, there are two types of changes we want to learn. First one, that's the first one, desirable change, and the second one, undesirable change. What is mean by desirable change? So the disruptive change is useful for the human. Useful for the human. So means that the fruits formation and some other changes, it's very useful for the human life. We get the food. So this is a very necessary change. So disruptive change means it is useful for the human. That is called disruptive change. What is mean by undisruptive change? That means entirely different. So that change is harmful for the human life. How do that one? For example, we are also purchasing the iron piece. After few days, what happened? For few months after, what happened? This iron going to degrade, rusting. So it is useful for human. No, it's a heavy lost, heavy cost. So that going to damage, it is also affect the human. And some food items we are prepared first. After few hours, that going to produce the false smell. So that is not good for the human. So some of the change is not good for the human life. That change is called undesirable change. So desirable change means useful for the human. Undesirable change means is harmful for the human. So I hope all of you understood the chapter physical and the chemical changes. It is a type of change. Today I am given only the introduction of the chemical and the physical change. Only introduction. So we want to learn, we want to understand what is mean by this change. What is the change and which type of change is there. And change is possible in their color and state and shape. So let's give you more information and more knowledge relating to this chapter in coming days. So this topic you want to read and learn carefully, and let's see in next week class. Thank you.